Now the latest from ITV News Anglia with Becky Jago and Jonathan Wills.
Good evening, welcome to ITV News Anglia.
Here's a look at tonight's main stories.
Two more people are arrested as police continue the grim task of moving the 39 bodies found in a lorry in Essex.
We see them getting out of the side of trailers and they're pulling the top, pulling back and getting out. Women with children and suitcases. It's just horrendous.
Also this evening, a state-of-the-art sanctuary for some of our most poorly children. We look around the region's new £10 million hospice.
Plus, a mother's joy as a life-saving drug for her son's cystic fibrosis is made available on the NHS. And...
Welcome to the studios of Anglia Television.
Two, one...
Cue music.
A night on the box. We're celebrating TV history in the east of England as Anglia hits the big 6-0. Hello from Becky Mee and welcome to this evening's programme.
Russell Hookey, ITV News.
Well, thanks for joining us for our special programme tonight.
Later in the programme, we are saying happy birthday to ourselves.
Heidi and Claire, and there's Dillis, Megan.
It's through the magic mirror as we celebrate Anglia's 60th birthday. Yes, I can see you, Miss Rosalind, along with another children's favourite from TV history.
And this is the weather chart when Anglia opened 60 years ago, a fairly blustery day right across the whole of the region. But how's the weather looking for the weekend? Join me at the end of the programme. I have the full weekend forecast, plus we've got a special guest too. See you in a bit.
Well, thank you very much, Donny. And that is where we are going to leave the studio for a while and head out into the newsroom because, as I'm sure you know now, we're celebrating a very special weekend. Anglia News is 60.
Be 60 this Sunday. We thought we'd give you a whistle-stop look at Anglia as it is today. So come on in here. This is the gallery where the magic takes place between 6 and 6.30. We've got Kevin, our director here, Sally, and we've also got David, who's running the marshal in the show at the moment. Say hello, guys. Hello.
Hello.
Evening.
Hello.
They're all very serious at the moment. Now, something I've always wanted to do forever and ever. Here we go. Cue Becky.
Yes, enjoy the power while you have it, Mr. Wills. This is our newsroom. It's rather wonderful, isn't it? Actually, it's quite quiet at the moment because we're on air, but usually there's a hive of activity while we get the programme ready for you.
Absolutely, but nothing says Anglia quite like this chap.
Look at that, our symbol all these years, the wonderful Anglia Knight, and I think looking just as sparkly and beautiful as it did back in 1959.
Absolutely.
Time on a wet and blustery autumn day 60 years ago. Anglia bringing commercial television to the east of England.
Welcome to the studios of Anglia Television.
Tuesday, the 27th of October, 1959. ITV had launched 4 years earlier. Anglia, one of the last regional stations to hit the airwaves.
Outside broadcast cameras will be there at important events, like the recent general election.
But it's a brand that's endured the full 60 years while other ITV companies have disappeared. In the early days, a strong tradition of drama with many famous faces on screen.
I want to watch television.
A bikini-clad Wendy Richard in an Anglia soap long before EastEnders.
I never believed in it much myself.
Michael Crawford, a young police constable. And many of the programmes made in the past six decades have become classic TV history.
It's the quiz of the week.
This 500cc motor car valued at £579 for only £62.80.
then, like now, a television station that aims to capture the essence of life in the eastern counties.
Hello, sir. Do you think women should wear trousers?
No.
I think they look much nicer in their frocks.
When do you think women should wear trousers?
Well, when they're doing the housework.
The news magazine programme about Anglia started in 1960.
Right now, John Bacon with the regional news.
A bus career downhill through the centre of Stamford today.
Perhaps it's a good day for a jackpot on our forecast chart. In Division 1, Ipswich to draw up at Newcastle. In Division 2, Norwich and Fulham to draw.
Well, I see from this that the 8:30 from Liverpool Street arrives at 11:11, but it doesn't.
Like everyone else in the 60s, I used to wear them too, almost up to my navel.
About Anglia became Anglia News, and now ITV News Anglia carries on.
I'm off to try and catch up with the experts. Good night.
David Hughes, ITV News.
Well, I'm delighted to say she's swapped the bicycle for the comfort of our sofa. Christy Webber, thanks so much for coming in.
Well,
some wonderful memories there.
I know. And all those friends, you know. Oh, gosh, yes. And what was I doing on a bicycle? I've no idea.
Cycling it beautifully.
You were looking pretty good on that bicycle. You were a star of the show in the 1980s.
Yeah, 79 to 1990, I suppose.
That's
yeah,
right. Yes, quite a long time, wasn't it? Yeah. Actually, here's a reminder of some of the stories that you covered.
We're standing outside one of the town's oldest theatres, the Hippodrome. And while we are outside enjoying the sun, inside, some people are working very hard indeed.
Just take a little pinch, because I think it's quite strong. Now, you can either put it on the back of your hand or you can just slip it, OK?
Meanwhile, back at the car park, Wonder Woman was still wending her way through the beginner's course.
You can't see yourself taking that off?
No. I'd rather have a cigarette.
We'll also be finding out how high fashion in time relates to the high street.
Would you like a little bit of first-hand experience inside?
Oh,
why don't you try it yourself in one of our cells? All right then.
Wow, you must have covered so many stories over
the years. Oh, real in-depth things like taking snuff, yes. Very good at those.
Do you have a favourite? Maybe one of those or a different one?
Oh, there was one where I was assaulted in a not very nice way by a dog live on air.
Oh, really?
But there were great
things. You're smiling
things
about it now.
Well, right. But there were good things, like, actually, earlier this week, I was looking at an old recording of the 5,000th about Anglia, where we had Prince Philip come in. And only very few people knew he was coming in. And he came even without a detective, and he just marched up the steps into the reception, and the receptionist nearly died. We just had a wonderful time, and still friends with so many people that I met then.
Just picking up on one of the things that we saw there with you doing this now, and again, that's one of the areas you'd say that Anglia hasn't changed. The engagement with the public, always so important for the programme.
Well, absolutely, and we were always, you know, flying the flag for the PR side of the company, you know, opening fetes and that sort of thing. So that was very good. And getting involved, like the round robin music we heard there, that was the social action slot, and that was to kind of encourage people to get involved with support groups where they needed them and that sort of thing. And that was a really good part of the job, really. Plus the medical slot where I met my lovely husband.
Of course you did.
Yeah.
Of course, times have changed, haven't they? And we don't see tigers in zoos, in circuses anymore.
No.
Yeah, I mean,
that's probably just as well.
Yeah.
But what I remember of that day was that there were two baby tigers, and a photographer thought it'd be wonderful if they got lots of pictures of me with these baby tigers round my neck. And they bit me scratched me, and they were walking around in absolute, you know, muck and everything. And I ended the day in Great Yarmouth Hospital having a tetanus injection.
Wow.
Oh, it's the glamour.
Well, I hope it still hasn't shock you too much. It's so much so that we're going to ask you to do just one other thing that takes you back to the day, hopefully. But just hold on there, Christine, because we've got a bit of one more task, haven't we?
Yeah, we're going to look back at another Anglia favourite from a few years before your time, actually. Yeah.
We only need to say the words, was it romper, bomper, stomper, do?
Tell me, tell me, tell me, do.
Another clue, it had a magic mirror. Mm. Natalie Gray has been meeting the star of the show.
Pop goes the weasel, and Jack in the Box jumps out of his house, which means it's time for Romper Room. And this is Miss Rosalind saying hello to all the boys and girls here and to all my friends at home.
Bet this brings back a few memories. Tragically, only two episodes have survived, and even they are a little worse for wear.
Romp, bumper, stomp, boo. Tell me, tell me, tell me, do. Magic mirror, tell me today. Have all my friends had fun at play?
Every child wanted you to repeat their names.
They did, they did.
And I see Steve and Jean. There's Joy and Michael, and I see Lynn, Heidi and Claire, and there's Dillis, Megan. I can see Harriet and Aldrin.
To begin with, of course, I had a list of names. And then if I didn't say their name, they, you know, eventually mothers would write in and ask if I could say names.
Now, they say never work with children and animals.
Tanya, do you think you could stand on the floor and do that instead of on your chair in case the chair wobbles and you fall off?
How was it working with children?
Oh, it was just great fun every time because you never knew what might happen in the programme. As it wasn't, it was unscripted and unrehearsed. It was as we did it.
Now, I gather that you beat Esther Ranson, of all people, to the role. Oh, she was it. She got down to the final six.
It's my claim to fame, really, isn't it? But didn't Esther do well later on? Hasn't she made a great career for herself? And when I came to do the first recording, I had a telegram from her wishing me well, and I thought that was so kind and thoughtful.
Look who is here, Punchinello, funny fellow. Look who is here, Punchinello, funny.
Well, I'm delighted to say that Sarah Jervis, who was on the first ever romper room in the Anglia region, is with us now. Welcome back to Anglia Television, Sarah. So go on then, tell us your memories. So you would have been five?
Nearly six, I would think, because my father came to Norwich in 1959 to help set up Anglia TV. When Romper Room started, they needed some children to be on that first week of shows. So they asked the staff whether they got any children of the right age, and he nominated me. I don't remember too much, but I have this memory of Miss Roslin used to ask the children to ask Mr. Music to play. Because we used to dance round, and I said, no, I don't want to ask Mr. Music to play, I need a wee-wee. So I promptly went and had a wee-wee.
And Miss Roslin, that wouldn't have been edited out, of course.
Not at all, no, the programme was not edited in any way. It was recorded, but it went out exactly, warts and all.
That's hilarious.
I know.
That's hilarious. What is it like, Sarah, meeting Miss Roslin again?
Oh, it's lovely. She hasn't changed at all.
Oh, that's
she
so
hasn't.
Kind.
Miss Roslin, I wonder if I can ask you one favour and look straight at camera and say goodbye to our viewers.
I see Sarah, and I can see Jonathan and Becky, and I can see Alan and Mary and David. There's David. And I can see you. And I hope to see you all again next time in Romper Room.
Goodbye.
Well, that was a programme that started in 1964, 5 years after the launch here at Anglia. And we are now at the, well, it's the heart of the news technical operation, really. We call it traffic, and it's in almost exactly the same place as the master control room was back in 1959. And someone who, well, hasn't been standing here all that time, but almost, is Wally Sparrow. And
hello,
you
everybody.
Were here, hello, so lovely to see you again. You were here the day Anglia launched. What was
yes.
it like?
Nervous, yeah. Apprehensive, but it all worked well on the opening night. And, of course, we were only on air between 4 and 11-ish, so there was none of the sort of long-term transmissions we do now.
Yeah.
But it worked well. The station was quite successful. We did drama. We did horse racing at Newmarket. We were the first company, I think, to put football on the television screen. We were the first company to make wildlife programmes in the term of countrymen locally and then survival nationally. And Anglia became a worldwide...
A huge success.
A huge success.
Yeah, thanks to people like you. I bet it's changed a lot now, hasn't it? Now you come here and see everything.
The technology is incredible.
Mm.
I mean, you can go anywhere in the world and you can see the pictures here in seconds, which
yeah.
is amazing. We had to have motorcycles, film processing, a lot of head scratching and a lot of smelly chemicals, and it's all gone.
I wonder if it's easier or harder now, I'm not sure. Very different, that's for sure. And you're going to stay around for our celebrations, aren't you, Wally?
I will indeed.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
Well, seeing as we're showing you all of Anglia's little secrets, let's go for another, shall we? But now, you may have noticed that during the evening, we sometimes send our weather presenter outside, especially if it's raining, because we like to do that, a bit of a laugh. Well, you may have wondered just how far away it is from the actual building. It's miles away, actually. It's all of about 5 feet. And here we have another legend from Anglia's history, Jim Bacon. Jim, lovely to see you. Thank you so much for coming in.
Great to be back.
And weather-wise, I mean, Anglia's been cutting edge from the start.
Yes, it started. I mean, it's one of the first companies that's had its own weather department. I grew up as a schoolboy watching Michael Hunt do the weather, got me my interest in it. And then over the years, it's always pioneered new innovations, computer graphics. We've seen satellites coming along. We've seen data from computer models, rainfall radar, all the things that I could have only dreamt of when I started.
There's a huge smile next to you from Ash. And what's it like standing next to this legend?
Well, it's really nice now because we've become friends over the last number of years, but it is literally a dream come true to follow in your footsteps, and I think me and Chris both think that, so we're really lucky.
And Jim, has weather predictions and weather meteorology, has it changed as you expected it to?
I think it has. Once I realised quite early on, I was sent to work in the Met Office on their supercomputer as a programmer, and that was the key. Computers were going to do the job going forward faster, do more, make it better able to show visualisations of the weather so you can see animating jet streams, all the things that make the weather really interesting that we could only dream of describing with words before. It's wonderful. It's in good hands, by the way, isn't it?
Well, that's great of you to say as well. And Ash, what's the next 60 years going to look like, do you think?
Who knows? But with quantum computing on the cards, we also have climate change to consider as well going forward. I think it's going to be an interesting 60 years.
Ash and Jim, thank you so much.
Pleasure. Nice to be here.
Well, let's head back into the studio, shall we? And seeing as it's a special occasion, we're going to give you not one, not two, but three wonderful weather presenters. And we'll get the forecast in a moment. But you've been catching up with another Anglia favourite, haven't you?
Yes, because it's our 60th birthday, we brought BC back out of retirement for this special occasion.
Birthday Club!
This is like a madhouse. Lots of love to you from Mummy, Daddy and your brother.
For a quarter of a century, BC helped wish younger viewers in the Anglia region a very happy birthday.
Hello, welcome to Birthday Club, and BC is going to make me a lovely pancake, aren't you? You're such a good boy. Now, the lovely Grace.
BC strayed into the Anglia studios in 1980, where he was discovered by presenter Helen McDermott, who made him the star he is today.
They've put us together. Well, there you are. Can't win them all. Anyway, welcome to BC's home. It's not bad, really, is it?
Oh, my gosh, memories of my childhood. And so you've teamed up with him.
Yes, and it was so much fun. And we just want to wish everyone that shares Anglia's 60th birthday with us. And so it's online now if you want to see the clip.
Wow.
Have you enjoyed your retirement? I've seen that you've been lazing on the beach, you've been sunning around on the world tours. Have you been enjoying that? Not really. Are you excited to be back, though, for our 60th birthday? Yes. And, oh, you're ready to do a bit of work, I hear, as well.
Well, the good news is, let's do this.
I'm so jealous. Yeah, it's so funny.
There were so many people that wrote in. It was brilliant. We, you know, we just couldn't get them all on. But we tried to mention as many as possible. And, for this special edition. And it's all available on our website and on our social media platforms. So please take a little look. Yeah, it was a lot of fun
to have a look. It is well worth it. I should say, don't give up the day job. Not because you weren't very, very good at it. Just because we do need to get the forecast tonight.
Yes. In fact, you've seen where the green screen area is. Let's head over now. And here's the weekend weather.
Greater Anglia, sponsor of ITV Anglia Weather.
Now, you may have been lucky enough first thing this morning to see a few glimmers of sunshine, but for most of us through today, we've held on to those fairly grey and cloudy skies. As for the weekend, well, it's a story of two halves. Saturday looks to be the wet and windy day, quite a lot of heavy rain in the forecast, but by Sunday, a more autumnal feel, cold, dry and staying fairly bright. Now, this is the weather front that's bringing in the rain as we go through this weekend. It stretches 3,000 miles into the Atlantic, would you believe, and it slowly creeps its way eastwards and southwards across the country as we go through the weekend, and that will bring us that wet weather as we go into Saturday. Tonight, though, the wind's starting to strengthen out there at the moment. Still some outbreaks of rain across northern and western parts, but elsewhere, I think, dry, with gusts here up to maybe 40 to 45 miles an hour towards our coastal sites. Temperatures, though, in that tropical air holding up between 14 and 15 degrees. degrees. So a mild start as we go into Saturday and a dry start for the further south and east you are. But as we go through the day, this rain does start to pile its way in from the north and the west. Notice these brighter colours in here. That suggests that we'll see something heavier. And by the afternoon, a real dismal afternoon to come. Wet and windy, top temperatures 15, maybe 16 degrees. Here, times of high water then, we're looking at Great Yarmouth there, 9 minutes past seven tomorrow morning and 15 minutes past eight tomorrow evening. Now, the cold air begins to dive its way in as we go into Sunday. You can just see spreading its way down across the whole of the country from the Arctic. So temperatures are set to turn a lot much lower as we go through the weekend. So, yes, a lot of wet weather in the forecast on Saturday, dry and bright, but cold on Sunday. And with a cold start, you may be pleased to know that the clocks go back by 1 hour on Sunday morning. So that could mean an extra hour in bed. If not, enjoy your weekend. Bye-bye.
Greater Anglia. Sponsor of ITV Anglia Weather.
And that is just about it on this very special day for Anglia. Here he comes. Always makes an impression, doesn't he, that boy?
Yeah, look, everyone has joined us. Thank you so much for coming in for our special anniversary. I hope you've enjoyed our look back. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, thanks to all again for our very special guest this evening. And, of course, to everyone at home. We couldn't do it without you, and we really do appreciate all the feedback we get from you.
We really, really do. Thank you so much for watching. So I guess we should just say happy 60th birthday, Anglia, shouldn't we?
We really should.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!